Today, we're going to create a sweet multicolor coaster from an SVG using Tinkercad. So let's get cracking. So as we get cracking, friends, this is my Patreon community. It is available to free members. You can ask questions like David did here. Has an SVG file, wants to make a coaster. Let me show you how to do it. If this is your first time visiting Tinkercad, you can get there at tinkercad.com. I simply choose sign in with Google. Today we're going to create a brand new design. I'm going to simply hit create 3D design, and our project is going to be a coaster. I'm going to start by naming the file. It is that easy. Once you've done that, if you back up to the main page, bingo, it is already saved to the cloud. It's that slick. I'm going to simply hit tinker this to re-enter. Now, David wanted to build a coaster, so let's start with a cylinder. So the first thing I would do is I would build the coaster base. I'm going to hold down shift, and I'm going to stretch this cylinder, and I want to make it 100 millimeters on a side. I'm going to change the height to 3 millimeters for how thick I want the coaster to be. I'm also going to take the sides, and I'm going to move them to the max so that it's smooth. Now the user has a design they want to use. They shared that with me. I'm going to import it. It is an SVG, and I had saved it in my downloads folder. When we bring this in, I'm going to choose art, and I know that my design right here is only 100 millimeters, so I'm going to take this and I'm going to shrink it down so it fits. I'm going to just type 90 for the largest measurement and press enter. When I choose import, it should actually fit in our design. Now the end result for the user is they want four colors. So what we're going to do is break this into four separate pieces. The background is going to be white. So if we wanted to make this two colors, we could be done right now. But because we want four colors, we need to make these half arcs as separate parts and then cut them away. We could make them with the half roof, but I want to make them with the awesome sketch tool. I'm going to bring the sketch tool out. I'm just going to set it down. I'm going to back out of the sketch tool, and I want to center it on the project. So I'm selecting everything, doing L for align, clicking on either of these pieces, and choosing center and center. Now when we double click to edit the sketch, we can zoom back out, and things are lined up a little bit better. Now I want to trace this, but I really am just going to trace it close. So I'm going to use the lines that are closer to whole numbers. So you can see here I'm just following this line right here, and then I'm going up to halfway, which I do know because we aligned it, is right there. And I'm going to press 2 to switch to Bezier curve mode, and I'm going to click, hold, and I'm going to stretch these along the same line. So I'm just getting close to that shape right there, once again, making sure that it's straight. Because I did that, I can now click here and finish, and we have just created a perfect half circle that's going to match what that design had. When I hit finish sketch, you can check that out. We're going to use this for a couple things. Of course, we need two of these to make the actual design. So I'm going to do Control D, Shift Nudge, and I'm going to mirror it with the mirror tool. And then we're going to nudge it into place. To make sure that I've got it fully selected, I'm making sure there's none of that gray poking out. I'm going to do that by putting 0.1 and doing one more click. That turned out perfect. It's cutting perfect on that side. Of course, I need to click on this one, and I need to nudge it as well. Notice I grabbed the gray one instead of the blue one, so now I'm going to nudge it out. All right, so let me show you how this works. We're going to click on the tan one, and we're going to hide it. I'm going to click on our new part that's going to be so useful. I'm going to shift select two of them. I'm going to do Control D to make a duplicate. I'm going to shift nudge it a little bit to the left. I'm going to group it, and I'm going to make it a hole. We're going to use that hole two times. These are going to stay separate, and these are going to cut in the location. So here's how this works. That's a lot of jumping around to make this happen, but trust me, it's useful. So the first way we're going to use this is to get the dots in so it's separate. Control D. Shift select the dots in, L to align, and once again, we want to make sure it's in the middle. When we do Control G, bingo, the dots in is all by itself. Now to make this print faster, I want my fancy colors to only sink in 1 millimeter. So we're going to click on this project, get it set to 1 millimeter nudge. We're going to do Control up 1, 2. Now we can select these parts again, L for align, and I want to choose the middle just like that. Now this time, I only want to cut in the white. So I'm selecting the white, I'm selecting our hole, and if we do Control G and hit T for transparent, you can now see that we've got the sunken area right there where one of our colors will be. We can take this piece and make it size 1. I do need to raise it up. We can just do Control up 1, 2 to get it to the top. Let's shut off transparency and let's pick the blue that I think that one was gonna be. And then we're gonna repeat the process up here. Once again, 1 millimeter, press enter, Control up 1, 2. And then this one needed to be red. And then finally, we're gonna do the same thing with the dots. And you can see it's all the way below. So I'm gonna do Control up 1, 2. I'm gonna do Control D to make a second one. And I'm gonna take the second one and I'm gonna lock it and I'm gonna hide it. I'm gonna make the other one a hole. You can see how that's gonna cut in the words once I select those two and do Control G. That is where the Dotson is gonna show up. If we do show all, it's back. Of course, now we simply need to unlock and set the height to size 1. The color we were gonna choose is likely black. Bang, we have just made the coaster. Now you can export this with the colors as an OBJ, but I don't like that process. The unzipping always annoys me. I choose separate STLs. Also, if you want to print it face down, this is where you would flip it, so that way it prints face down and gives you that cool texture. To export it as 4 pieces, we simply do export. Notice it's just the selected shape, STL. I'm going to call the name coaster base, and then I'm going to hide that one, and then repeat that step with each additional piece, always giving it a different name. I'm going to do show all just so it's all back. We could also flip it back if that's the view you preferred. Of course, then we would bounce to Bamboo Web Studio. I'm going to choose create a new 3D project. When we do add, we simply grab them all at once and hit open. I do want it to be a single object, multiple parts. If we switch to object mode, you can now see your pieces and flip your colors. Now, I'm not going to actually print this because I don't have a need for a Dotson coaster, but let me get the colors as close as I can. The blue is blue. I'm going to make the word yellow. I'm going to make the red red. And let's do the base as the awesome bubblegum pink from Polar Filament. And if we peek underneath, there's our cool coaster. And it would take about 1 hour and 8 minutes to create it. Friends, as I wrap up, I want to thank David for the question. I also want to highlight this is a fantastic use of the free community you can find at my Patreon. Once again, these are totally free. If you have got a wish, you can simply submit it down below. I do want to highlight that after you do the first submission, you need to click on the design and then go down here on the right to add comments, replies, or other images about the project you're hoping I'll create. I also want to say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support, and with any support, you get early access to videos. I do want to send a shout out to all of my supporters via Patreon as well. I showed you the messaging area a moment ago. It is absolutely fantastic. You can, of course, learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.